Hello my dear students, in this video I'll continue with the further methods that we can use in order to handle the Excel sheets through the OpenTY Excel module. Right, in the previous video also I have clearly told you that the methods that have been mentioned in the textbook are not at all going to work with the version of the Python that is available in your system right now. So for that, please do concentrate on all the methods that I'm going to use here. The purpose of the methods are going to remain as same, but the syntax that is being used with the latest version of this Python install is going to be different as compared with the methods that has been mentioned in your textbook. Okay, so to do concentrate here. So I'm not going to discuss anything theoretically. Directly I'm going to deal with the programs here. So in the programs itself, I'm going to explain you the all the methods that you can use to handle the Excel sheets and all the things that you can do with the Excel sheets through the Python program using the OpenTY Excel module here. So let's continue here. So here you can see here what we have to do in order to handle or in order to work with the Excel sheets through the Python program. You need to import a module known as the OpenTY Excel module. Right. So within that, you need to see here from OpenTY Excel dot utils. So this is going to be different as compared to the method that has been mentioned in the textbook. So you can, if you want, you can compare with your textbook example as well. Right. So OpenTY Excel dot utils, within that you need to import the two more methods here known as a get column letter and get index from the string. So this example is with respect to the how you are going to handle the column letters to the index values and the index values back to the letters here. Right. So in order to work with any Excel file, first you need to load that Excel file using the method known as the load workbook. So for which you need to specify the name of the file that you want to work here. So in this example, it is example.xlsx. So once you do that, next if you are interested to know the or you need to create an object with respect to the sheets that are associated with this Excel file. So for example, in this Excel file, you can see here there are the three sheets here: A division sheet, B division sheet, and the A division 2017 scheme sheet. So in order to create an object with respect to these sheets, you need to use the method known as the wp.sheetNames. So within this sheet names, you want to access only the one particular sheet named as a A division. So that means this one. So in this case, if you are interested to deal with this sheet, so you need to specify the name of the sheet that is given at the bottom of the Excel file here. So how to do that now? So that is done in the case of WB. So WB is an object that has been created while loading the Excel file itself. So to this object, within the square bracket, within the single quote, you need to mention the name of the sheet here. So in this example, we have taken the example of the A division sheet here. So once that is done, this is an object which is going to point to this sheet within that Excel file. So that means the sheet is going to refer to the A division sheet here. So within that, what we are interested is we want to know the column name that is associated with the first column here. So if you are not going to do this method, by default it is going to give you its a numerical representation of the column. For example, the column 1, column 2, and so on. So in case, if you want to actually know the column labels in terms of the letters that are associated with any column, you need to use a method known as a get column letter, get underscore column underscore letter, and the parameter to this method is a numeric value representing the column number here. So I'll just show you here. So you can see here at the top you have the column label as a A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, and so on. In case if you want to actually know the names of these columns as it is, instead of getting them as a 1, 2 and 3 and so on, you want to know actually the labels in terms of the letters itself. In that case, you can go for using the method known as a get column letter with specific column number here. Right, so if I execute this function. So do not worry about the rest of the outputs here. So there are so many other methods that I have covered in this example for which it is showing the output as well. So as I explain the each and every method, you will get to know the for what purpose the method is used and what is the supposed output that you are going to get. So right now you just concentrate only on the methods that I'm directly discussing here. You can see here print get column of one letter one. So get column letter of one means the first column level is A here. So similarly, if you to take it as a 2, it is going to show you B. So if you take it as a 27, if you want, you can cross check with the Excel file. You can open the any Excel file, try to run these methods and specify the different values here just to check what levels you are going to get here. So for the column number 27, it is A. And for the 900, it is AHV and so on, right? So here you can see there is a one more parameter that you have mentioned here. So instead of giving a numeric value to this method, here what we are doing is we are passing the sheet dot max row. That means the numeric value has to be considered for the last row value, that is the maximum row value. So in that case, you are going to get the column level as the AHP as an answer over here. Sorry, BR as an answer over here. Right. So similarly, vice versa. In case, in any cases, just in case, if you want the numeric representation with respect to the any column level, even you can get that as well using the method known as a column index form string. The name of the method is column underscore index underscore from underscore string by taking the label, the letter as a parameter over here. So for which it is going to give you the numeric representation here. You can see here the result for this line here is 1. The column number for A is 1. So the column number for AA is 27. So like this, whenever you are interested, or you are, in case if you require in any of the examples, that so that you can get the column label and the column numbers to be interchangeable, you can go for using the methods known as the get column letter and the column index from the string. So I hope these two methods are clear to you people. So the next example you can see here, what we have taken here, we are interested to get a result in the form of a tuple data structure, that we have taken it as a tuple. And here we have taken as a sheet object. So sheet object is with respect to the A division sheet. Within this we have taken a slicing concept here. So that means we want the tuple of the sheet level addresses ranging from the A1 till C3 column. For example, here from this A1, in the sense this one, till C3 column, so till here. So we want the labels of these lists here, A1 till C3. So you can see here you are getting here cell A division dot A1. So the next part of the next cell from the A division is, it is a merged value, merged cell. So that's why it is giving here as a merged cell A division dot B1 and so on. So you can just cross check with the Excel file as well. So what you are getting here, so these are the labels of that particular cell ranging from the A1 to C3. So whatever the cell that are being covered from the A1 till C2, the label of the each cell is going to be given as a result here in the form of a tuple. So further, what we have taken here, so in case if you want to just give the value associated with the each cell, if you want to retrieve the value associated with the each cell from the Excel file, at that time you can go for using the for loop here. So the nested for loop can be used in order to access the value associated with the each cell from the Excel file. So we'll see what has been done here. So here you can see we have used the outer for loop. This is an iteration variable. Row of cell objects is an iteration variable, and where you want to apply it on a sheet, that is A division, ranging from the A9 cell to the D15 cell. So in this case, A9 in the sense A here, and the 9th is this one. So A9 to the D16. So D16 in the sense 15 here, till here. So this till this. So these value you want to fetch as a result for the for loop that has been written over here. I am telling you A9 in the sense 8th column with the 9th row, and D16 in the sense D-th column with the D15th row. So as the indexing is going to be considered one value less to the ranging there, so it is going to consider till here. So we will see what has been done further here. A9 to D16, and within this for cell object in the row of cells, within this cells print the value of associated, that is the label of that cell along with the cell value over it. So the same thing has been done as the output over here. So you can see here A9, starting with that A9 1, B9 1. So the value here is A9 1. This is B9 1, and further. So further you can see here A9 1. You are getting the A9 1. This value B9 1. And this C9 is this USN number, C9 is this USN number, and similarly the D9 is the name of that student, that is the Abhishek Gowdar, and this is the end of the row. So the same thing is going to repeat for the rest of the values till it come across with the D16. So you can see here it even has considered for the last value as well in this Excel sheet. So though for the other for loops it is going to consider one value to the last range, in the Excel file you can consider that it is going to extract till the last value from that range either. So A16 is this one, this 8, and B16 is 8, and C16 is this USN, and the name of the student at the D16 is Bhagyashree Bogar. You can see here Bhagyashree Bogar, and the end of the row. So this is how you will be able to extract the values, the set of the values from the Excel file. So for that, what you are supposed to do is you are supposed to use the nested for loop on a sheet on which you want to extract the values, and within the sheet object you need to specify the range of the rows and the columns from where you want to fetch the values, and within that you can see here in order to get the label, instead of taking it as an index column or the get column or the index from the string, you can directly use a method known as a coordinate cell object. So the iteration value variable dot coordinate, this is going to give you the label of that particular cell, and in order to get the value associated with that cell is the method is dot value. So iteration variable dot value. So do remember that dot coordinate is used for getting the label of a cell, whereas the dot value is going to used to get the value associated with that cell. So in the next case here, what has been done here, sheet dot columns of 3 has been used. So what this is going to do here, I'll just show you with the output. So it is going to give you the column labels of the all the cells from the column 3. So you can see here sheet is an object associated with the A division, and the method that we have used is columns. We are interested only with respect to the labels of the columns, but which column we want the labels, we want the all the labels, the cells of the labels from the column 3. So I'll just show you column 3 in the sense this one. So for this I want the labels over here. So what the result I'm getting here, so you can see here we are getting the A division dot D1 and D8, D, and so on. So whatever the labels that is going to be applied for that particular cell, that is going to be considered as a result over here, right? So in the next case, what we are interested here is we are interested to get the value value that has been associated with the each cell of that column. So how to get that? Always you can go for using the for loop. In the list sheet dot columns, we are interested in the column 3, and we want to print the value associated with the each cell here. So for that, iteration variable dot value. So as I told you, in case if you are interested in getting the value, you need to use the method known as a dot value. So we'll see what result we have got here. You can see here we have got the results of all the column 3. I think as a column name, this is considered as 0th column, 1th column, 2th column, and this is the third column. So for this it is not going to give you the result, because the beginning of the rows are the merged cells here. So for that you are getting the result as a none here. So you can see here the result as a none for the beginning of the few rows. For the next of the value, that is from here, you are going to get the all the result as a name of the students, with the all the names here. So you can see here you are able to fetch the all the names here. This is the result of the this particular for loop, the last for loop, where you want the values to be fetched together with the one column. So for that, what you need to use, you need to use the dot columns as a method in order to direct it to a particular column by specifying the column number into the index, and then you need to print that value associated with the each cell of that column by using the dot value with respect to the iteration variable. So I hope all these methods are clear to you. The first method is get column letter in order to get the label of a column with specific number, and next you want to get a number, numeric value associated with the string. For that you can go for using the column index from the string. And next case is how you'll be able to access the group of values from the each cell ranging from the one row to the one column value. So for that you can go for using the nested for loop with a method known as a dot coordinate and the dot value. Dot coordinate is used for getting the label of the cell, and dot value is used for getting the actual value of that cell. So in this next case also, in case if you want only the column values to be fetched, at that time you can go for using the dot columns with the specific column number, and to get the value again it is a dot value. So further things I'll continue in the next video.